In my last video, I talked about how you can use Playwright along with Scrapy. We scraped this page, which is dynamic using Playwright, and the result was that we scraped 40 items, but it took us 102 seconds. Today, I'm going to talk about few things that you can do to bring down this time to 27 seconds, at the same time improving the stability and guarantee that the spider is going to run all the time. Excited? Let's get started. This is the code that we wrote, and it was not working on the first attempt. The reason was that one of the requests was taking more than 30 seconds, which is the default timeout. The solution that we did was in the settings, we changed this default navigation timeout to 100 seconds. This 100,000 means 100 milliseconds, so 100 seconds effectively, and it started working. But that is not the best way. There are much better ways to handle this kind of scenario. Now, before I talk about this particular website, let me talk about this website. If you look at this website, this is Codes to Scrape, and it has /js delayed. What happens if I press Command R to reload the page? Here you will see that there is no loading animation. The page has loaded as per all the page events. There was some delay before the content actually appeared. This can happen when there are certain requests in the background which are taking time. How do you handle this? You simply inform Playwright to wait for specific elements. For example, we can create a selector. Let's say wait for quotes placeholder, and only then you continue. How do we do that? If we go to the documentation of Playwright, if we look at the page class, there are many page methods that can be useful in this scenario. Specifically, this page.waitForSelector. What it will do is it will wait for a selector and it will wait for that element to become visible. How do we use these page methods in a Scrapy spider? Let's come back to the code, and we are going to work with this code spider first. That's easier to work with and easier to understand the concept. Here in the meta dictionary, we are passing Playwright true. This is the most important dictionary key. The second one is actually very obvious now that you know the concept, that we need to use page methods. What we are going to do is Playwright underscore page underscore methods. This is the dictionary key, and this is actually a list. We can actually use as many of these page methods. Today we are going to work with wait for selector. You cannot directly use page methods. What you have to do is you have to use one helper class. This is called page method. And of course, this we need to import. And this is in Scrapy Playwright page methods. Just import it. We have the import added by PyCharm. It will take two parameters. Number one, which page method we want to use? We want to use wait for selector. This is the page method that we want to use. And what is the selector that you want to use? The selector that we want to use is, let's use this one, dot quote. This is going to wait until the page has at least one element with dot quote class. And one more thing, this is actually page methods because we can provide more than one. All right, I'm going to format the code and everything looks okay. So now let's go to the terminal and run it. Scrapy crawl delay. That is the name of the spider that I gave. It's going to launch the browser now. The browser has launched, the page is loading, the page has loaded. The loading animation is complete, but it is still waiting. It will wait until that content appears and then the browser window will close. There we go. We can see here that we have 10 items scraped, and here we can see all the items scraped. So now that you understand the concept, let's apply the same thing here on Lazada. Number one, we are going to make a selector. Actually, we already have this selector. We can actually wait for this particular selector. We are going to add one more key, and this is going to be Playwright underscore page underscore methods. It's plural because it's a list. And this will be an instance of page method, and wait for selector. That is the name of the method that we want to execute. And the parameter that we want to send to this method is this selector. This is step one. I'll change it to single quotes. It's just that the waiting is more accurate. But even this spider is not going to work. We need to go to part two of the optimization. What is the part two of the optimization? See, what we will do is we will try to identify which request is taking time, and if it is possible to bypass that, why not bypass it? we can skip certain requests using Playwright. This capability of Playwright to stop certain requests from being sent is very useful because we can do two things. For example, we can skip certain requests which are taking time, or we can also skip things or requests which are totally useless. For example, if you look at this site, these images, they serve no value. What we are doing from this page is we are only getting this link. And to get this link, these images are useless. Loading these images takes time. And if you want to make the scraping fast, we can skip loading the images altogether, right? Let's see how we can do that. I'm going to create one function in the same file. This is not the best practice to create functions here. You should have these in a common file. Call it helper or something like that. And let's call this should about request, and it will take the request. We can check certain things about this request, what kind of request it is. And if we return true, then that request will be aborted. For simplest example is if request.resourceType is image, return true. Otherwise, return false. None of the images will be loaded if we enable this. So far, we have not yet enabled. We need to add something to the settings as well. If we want this to be applicable for the entire project, we can add it to the settings, or we can add a custom setting. Now, what is the name of the setting? Any guesses? We'll begin with Playwright. There will be underscore, and this is going to be about request. This is the dictionary key, and then what will be the value? The value will be the name of this function. Only this function name or the function reference. Don't call this function here. Let's run this as it is and see what is the impact. Let's jump to the terminal. Scrapy crawl and the name of the spider. There we go. We have the browser launched. The page is loading. And as you can see that the images are not loading. In the background, you can see all the activity which is going on, but none of the images loaded. And we can already see that the scraping is continuing. All the regular Scrapy requests have been sent, and let's see how many items have been scraped. We can see that all the 40 items were scraped. So there are a few more interesting things that you can do with this method. Let me show you the documentation. This is the request class, and I'm looking at the Playwright for Python documentation. I've just changed the language to Python. By default, it is usually Node.js. But anyway, these are all the things you can check. You can check the headers. You can check request methods. You can check whether you want to skip post request or get request or something like that. You can check what is the request URL. You can skip that. There are a lot of things that we can do. Phil, let me show you one more example actually. If, let's say, request.method. Let's say I want to skip all the post requests. I know that after some analysis that the post is useless for getting the data. Request.method. And let me convert to lower and post. Then also return true. What will happen? These two things, and let me change the setting and make sure that this is not needed anymore. Let me just comment it out. Now you can see that we removed that 100,000 milliseconds. We are skipping images and we are skipping all the post requests. You can do is you can actually comment out this launch options headers false. You can do that and it will be faster. Let me do one more thing. I'm going to set the log level to info. I'm going to skip all those debug messages. They are like too many to read. If things are not going fine, then maybe I'll go through all those. But for now, we can see that the browser Chromium has been launched. And there we go. The scraping is complete. We can see item scraped count 40. And how much time it took? It took 23 seconds. Isn't that a great improvement? That's it for now. I'll see you in the next one.